Hi there! Have you been itching to hear the hottest and trending gist from the world of? Look no further. This is where the blueprint of entertainment lives. You are in good company. This is NX Daily Top 10. At number 10, Robbers Told Me to Sing After Robbing Me, says Banky W.
I don't wanna pretend, I'm swimming in a deep end. From the very first day I see you, couldn't wait till the weekend. I was all up in your DM.
Banky W has shared his experience with robbers who told him to sing for them after robbing him in Lagos Island. The singer, who spoke at the program hosted by gospel artist Tim Godfrey, said the incident occurred on a certain December 31st night crossover service after he dropped off a friend. Banky W said, and I quote, "I recall that after a certain December 31st night crossover service, I was on my way to the island after dropping a friend. On getting to where my friends were, I stopped and I alighted. The next thing I felt was a slap at my face. Lo and behold, I saw four armed robbers. I opted to give them the key of my rickety car. They slapped me again, saying, 'Who wants your car?' They told me to move to the back seat of the car while they used my car to rob others. They took my money, jewelry, phone, and cap." He further added, "At one point, one of the armed robbers told the others, 'Let us take him to Aja and kill him.' I started begging them not to kill me. I told them I'm a singer. They then asked me to tell them the songs I had recorded. When I mentioned Ebute Metta, Capable, and others, the robbers expressed surprise, saying, 'So you are Mr. Capable. Sing for us.' That was the scariest free show I ever did in my life. I had to sing to armed robbers." End of quote. At number 9, months after xenophobia attack subsides, Burna Boy confirms performance in South Africa.
She want getting more dollar. She know they find that the body we go control her. Nah, nah, say she be foreigner. And these days she done the popular. She say she no getting no time for me now.
Burna Boy has confirmed rumors of his scheduled performance in South Africa months after weighing in on recent xenophobic attacks in the country. In a recent tweet, Burna Boy noted that the show, which is tagged Africans Unite, will be the first of many. He also hinted that he will donate part of the proceeds from the show to victims of xenophobic attacks in the country. At number 8, Nigerian couple ride home on a bike after their wedding in Rivers State. A newly married couple decided to do something different on their wedding day, and they are now the talk of the town. According to a social media user who shared the photos, this couple got married over the weekend in Bonny Island, Rivers State, and the husband drove his wife home afterwards on a bike. From the look of the pictures, both the bride and the groom seemed happy and proud about it. May God bless their union. The marriage starts after the wedding, and simplicity does it best. At number 7, Oba Elegushi celebrates first wife Olori Shekinat in reassuring birthday post. Oba Elegushi, who took the second wife a few months back, has sent a reassuring birthday message to his first wife Olori Shekinat. Celebrating her on her birthday, the monarch took to Instagram to say, and I quote, "Birthdays may come and go, but a wife like you is one in a million. I am so glad that I was able to find someone as perfect as you. My love and respect for you will never fade. Happy birthday, my love." End of quote. Davido and Chioma celebrates the naming ceremony of the newborn baby.
Love is sweet, oh. When money enter, love is sweet. Pepe resto. So brother man go gas deliver. Call Anita, oh. Ella make she come, they go far away. Far away. Me I know they do again.
On Saturday, November 9th, Davido and Chioma christened their newborn son Ifeanyi Adeleke at a ceremony that took place in the UK. The event was attended by family and friends of the couple. Davido decided to pray for his son on his christening while thanking God for his family, his relationship, and his business. While praying, Davido also revealed how strong Chioma was during the pregnancy while he was touring and busy recording his album. He also shared how he spent 12 hours with her during her labor and how they have several ups and downs since he met her at the age of 18. At number 5, Linda KG reveals how she stayed relevant over the years. Celebrity blogger Linda KG has taken to her Instagram page to reveal how she stayed relevant in limelight for over 13 years. The celebrity blogger and mother of one revealed that she is the most searched Nigerian woman in the last 10 years. The blogger also revealed that at most occasions she attends, people always query her on how she has stayed relevant in the industry for a very long time. According to Linda, she has stayed relevant in the industry because she has constantly reinvented herself. At number 4, Life of a Man is Hard, comedian Bovi reveals. Nigerian comedian, actor and writer Bovi took to his Instagram page to lament the responsibilities that comes with being a man. According to Bovi, the life of a man is hard in the sense that he never stops paying bills. The comedian said he wondered why he cannot be gifted an iPhone, while also stating that he ended up paying for a phone that was once gifted to him. At number 3, Emmanuel Adebayo seems to have splitted with Delish. Emmanuel Adebayo and Delish Matthews seem to have gone their separate ways over an undisclosed issue. The footballer hinted on their breakup following an Instagram exchange he had with a follower. Adebayo stated that he has nothing to do in Namibia when asked if he will be visiting the country soon after being reminded that his girlfriend lives there. At number 2, Davido rocks custom-made Cartier eyeglasses worth 4.4 million naira. Preparation for David and Choma's child naming ceremony, Davido was pictured wearing a custom-made Cartier eyeglasses with diamonds added by Icebox and is valued at £11,000. Oops! Davido actually seemed unbothered about accumulated expenses. At number 1, Will Mouth stuns the audience at his just-concluded comedy show tagged My Journey to Lagos. Ace comedian Will Mouth has proved himself beyond doubt that he is capable of holding the entire lovers of comedy in Lagos and beyond with his craft. This year's edition was centered around his journey to Lagos. The event was graced by several popular comedians in the comedy industry. Even though the event started at a very late hour, leaving the guests waiting a few hours after the initially announced startup time, the event, however, recorded it a success, and it is safe to say that all guests were fully entertained. Here are the highlights of the event.
When I travel go abroad, if they talk about the journey to Lagos, if you hear my journey from London, you know, say you delay. The country is learning. Now, when I travel go London, I realize, say, London get airport. Nigeria just get compound where they put plane. As in, and especially the way that they take announced flight for London, the way that they take announced flight from here, forever they go here,
attention please, all passengers on British Airways to Lagos should please proceed for boarding.
You don't hear MM2 own. But I said that girl, they need to sack him. Or maybe they train them English. What do they hear now? Bing,
bing. Intention, please.
Intention to do what? What is your intention in life? You will hear,
all passengers on so-so-so airline should come forward for refreshment. They won't cancel the flight.
And even when they say welcome business class and economy, it's different. They look and say, whether or not the economy be the real economy for the problem. Is a business, what's your seat number? 1A, please follow me. Can you just sit down here? Economy. They're first nice because they don't know what thing you get. What's your seat number? 51B. Join them. Keep going straight. Your left, put your back there and sit down quietly. And economy, they serve you with respect. Good afternoon, sir. Do you care for rice? We have small chops. We have big chops. We have all the chops. Which of the chops would you like to chop? So business, I'll come to form like, say, it'll be the same time we go land. Can I start with dessert? Say, no problem. Economy. Once they push that thing, they come like this. They tell you, okay, please move your leg. Let's move your leg, move your leg. And if you dare, they can't give you 4. Give it to your colleagues on this row.
Word. Wow.
Before I continue, get a pen and a jotter and jot things down. In order for you to work, take things.
Sorry.
Sorry.
I got
sorry.
You.
For example, let me just make a little quick example. This light that shines above us. You know that this light, the way this light is, it has an elder brother, which is the sun. The elder brother is the sun.
Wow. Wow. Wow.
You know that sun shines all over, like it shines on Africa, like African shiner.
Wow.
What kind of machine? It does blue. One of my guy, he go buy Igbo. As he dey come, now he just get alert. He say, may enter bank. This is his true life story for a boy. He went at day school. He say, may enter bank, just withdraw the money. Now, If they try enter the bank, the door not agree. If they try enter the door, not agree. Now he discovers a bill and say, now this Igbo where they pocket. And you know, say bank, they get boxes where you they keep safe, where you they keep things. Now he keep it home for number 4. He lock him. Mistake when he do, he not carry the key. As he enter bank, come out, number 4, they open. I want to tell people around, say he go the loss. Now, as they try, they find, they calculate. Now, one woman come out of the bank, open number 7, pick out umbrella. He say, excuse me, ma. Say, what is he? Say, ma, when I came, I tried to enter. The door did not allow me. I tried. It did not allow me. So I say, let me drop this black thing I was carrying inside nylon. I kept it inside. When I came out, I did not see my black nylon. The question when the woman asked now, what is inside the nylon? He look and say, madam, don't worry. He called security. Say, please, my something is inside a black nylon. You were here now. I was entering, it did not enter. I was entering, it did not enter. I kept it inside here. It did not, I came back now, I did not see it. Now the security man asked him, what is inside? Say, don't worry. I seen there around, they find. You know, say for a bank, although mopo, that they there across the street. One of them, they see and they roam around. I say, hey, you, come here. What are you looking for? Only the mouth order. Now the police officer collect the Igbo. As he say, what are you looking for? He say, oh, officer, what I'm looking for is in your mouth. If you remain, just give me.
Connect with us on all social media platforms at Nigeria Extreme for this and many more related stories.